Hi, I'm Ufoma Ogaga from Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. In this tutorial, I'll explain what a restricted fund is and show you how to record restricted contributions for your ministry in QuickBooks Online. Note that you must be using QuickBooks Online Plus or QuickBooks Online Advanced subscription to follow along with this video series. In addition to that, you need to create all of these items in your own QuickBooks Online file. I've done videos on how to create your customers, products and services, classes, and location tracking in QuickBooks Online. Click the link in the description box to watch the playlist on how to create all of these items in your own file. Here's an example of a check of $5,000 that we received from various donors for the Mission Fund to provide food to kids in need nationwide. Let's go into QuickBooks Online to record this restricted contribution. Since we received the funds by check, I'm going to use the sales receipt feature to record this transaction. Click on the plus new icon and select sales receipt. I'm going to select my outreach ministry mission fund project as my customer. Remember, if you are using an external donor management system to track all the details of your donors, you don't have to recreate the donor's name or all of those donor information in QuickBooks Online again. I'll enter the payment date as my sales receipt date, select my payment method, enter a reference number that matches the data in my external donor management system, or enter the check number. For the deposit to field, I'll select my undeposited funds. I'm going to keep my location tracking as with donor restriction. For the product and service, I'll select donation and enter the purpose of the check in the description field. Quantity will be 1 and the rate will be 5,000. QuickBooks will automatically do the math for the amount field. My class will be the temporary restricted class, since the funds are meant to be spent for a purpose within 1 year. I created my restricted class to match the same thing as my net asset accounts because my fund names are already projects and I don't need to recreate the wheel. You have an option of adding a copy of the check or any other supporting documents in the attachment box. Do one last review of everything, then click Save and Close. Now it is time to make the bank deposit. I'll click the plus new icon again and select bank deposits under the other column. In this deposit window, I will select my checking account and select my payment date. I'll change the location tracking to with donor restriction and select the box next to my sales receipt. Do one final review, then click Save and Close. That is a simple way to record your restricted contribution in QuickBooks Online. In an upcoming video, I will show you how to record the related expenses for your restricted funds in QuickBooks Online. Subscribe to my channel to get notified when I post that video.